Hello viewers, if you are new to the channel, please hit the like and subscribe button and share it with your friends. Also, click on the bell icon so that you get the latest information about the videos that are uploaded on this channel. Hello students, welcome back to the new video. In today's session, we will discuss the textual exercise of chapter 4, He. So, let's start with the first question, fill in the blanks. The first one is, the hotness of an object is determined by its temperature. Because you have already learned that temperature is the degree of hotness or coldness of a body. Second one, temperature of boiling water cannot be measured by a dash thermometer. Here it is given, cannot be measured. So, the answer is clinical thermometer. What is the reason? Because the temperature of boiling water can be measured only with a laboratory thermometer. But here it is given, cannot be measured. So the answer is clinical thermometer. Next one is, temperature is measured in degree. The answer is Celsius. The unit is asked here, temperature is measured in degree Celsius. The next one is, no medium is required for the transfer of heat by the process. You have learned about three modes of heat transfer. In that, the radiation mode of heat transfer does not require any medium. So here, what is the answer? Radiation. Radiation does not require any medium for the heat transfer. The next one is, a cold steel spoon is dipped in a cup of hot milk. Heat is transferred to its other end by the process of dash. Here you have to understand that hot milk is taken in a cup and a cold spoon is dipped in it. So, one end is dipped in the hot milk and how does the other end of the spoon get hot? You have learned that conduction process needs the contact. Therefore, the spoon is in contact with the hot milk. Therefore, here the heat transfer takes place by the process of conduction. So, conduction is the answer. Now, the next one, clothes of dash colors absorb more heat better than clothes of light colors. Here you have learned that dark or black colored clothes can absorb more heat whereas the light color releases or reflects heat. Therefore, what is the answer? Clothes of dark colors absorb more heat better than clothes of light colors. So students, now we will see the question number 2 match the following. Here in the column A is given land breeze blows during and the options are given here. You must remember that land breeze takes place at night. It blows from the land towards the sea. Therefore, the first answer is night. Second one, sea breeze blows during day. The correct answer is day. Because you know that sea breeze moves from sea towards the land, that takes place in the daytime. The third one is, dark colored clothes are preferred during. Dark colored absorb more heat. Therefore, in which season this type of clothes will be preferred? It is preferred in winter. Therefore, the correct answer is winter. The next one is light colored clothes are preferred during. You know that light colored clothes reflect maximum heat that falls on it. Therefore, the correct answer is summer. So students, moving further, let us discuss the question number 3, multiple choice questions. The first one is, 1 liter of water at 30 degree Celsius is mixed with water at 50 degree Celsius. The temperature of the mixture will be. Here what is there? We have water at 30 degree Celsius and water at 50 degree Celsius. Both are mixed. So what will be the temperature of the mixture? That is the question. According to the concept of heat, heat transfer always takes place from higher temperature to lower temperature and it will continue to flow till both the objects are at equal temperature. That means the temperature of the resulting mixture must be between 30 and 50 degrees Celsius. Okay. So where is that option given? First one is 80 degrees Celsius. It's not the correct answer. More than 50 degree but less than 80 degree. That is also not the correct answer. 20 degrees Celsius. That is also not correct. So what is the correct answer? Between 30 degrees Celsius and 50 degrees Celsius. So this is the correct answer, option number D. Now, the next question is, iron ball at 40 degrees Celsius is dropped in a mug containing water at 40 degrees Celsius. The heat flow. Here also the same concept is used. Iron ball and water both are at 40 degrees Celsius. So, will there be any heat flow taking place? Obviously, not. Because both are at equal temperature. So, what will be the correct option? It must be the option C. That is, no heat will not flow from iron ball to water or from water to iron ball. That means, in both the way, the heat flow will not take place. It means that the correct option is option number C. Question number 3 is, a wooden spoon is dipped in a cup of ice cream. Its other end. See children, to solve this question, we have to think about the properties of wood. You know that wood is a bad conductor of heat. It does not allow the heat to pass through it. So, if it is dipped in the ice cream, it will become cold by the process of conduction. Convection or radiation, all these three are not the correct answer. But what will be the correct answer? It does not become cold because wood is a bad conductor of heat. It will not allow the heat to transfer through it. So moving further, let us see the fourth question. Stainless steel pans are usually provided with copper bottoms. The reason for this could be that. Here we have to remember about the property of copper. Copper is a best conductor of heat. So, copper bottom makes the pan more durable. That is not the correct option. Such pans are appear colorful. That also not. Copper is a better conductor of heat than the stainless steel. That is, the option number C is the correct answer. Students, now we will see the fourth type of questions, that is, answer the following. The first one is state similarities and differences between the laboratory thermometer and the clinical thermometer. Both type of thermometers you have already learned. So let us see the similarities first. Both thermometers, that is clinical and laboratory thermometers, are made of glass and both of them have a long narrow capillary tube. Second point, at one end of both the thermometers there is a bulb. Third point, bulb of both thermometers are having mercury in it. And the fourth one is Celsius scale is marked in both thermometers as their unit. Now let us understand the differences between clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. In clinical thermometer, the first point is its use. A clinical thermometer is used to measure the human body temperature, whereas a laboratory thermometer is used to measure the temperature of any other objects. Second point, the range of temperature that is marked in the thermometer is 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius in a clinical thermometer, whereas this range is from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius in a laboratory thermometer. Third point is, that is clinical thermometer has a kink in it which prevents the immediate backflow of the mercury into the bulb, whereas a laboratory thermometer does not have any kink. So these are the differences between a clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. So students, now let us see the question number 2. It is a give reason question. Wearing more layers of clothing during winter keep us warmer than wearing just one thick piece of clothing. What is the reason for that? You know, when we wear more layers of clothing, between each layer the air gets trapped. And you know that air is a bad conductor of heat. So between each layer of clothing the air is there. That air will not allow our body heat to escape into the surrounding. This will help to keep our body warm. Students, let us see the third question. In places of hot climate, it is advised that the outer walls of houses be painted white. Explain. That is the question. You know that white color is a poor absorber of heat. Maximum heat that falls on the white color is getting reflected back. Therefore, if the outer walls of a house in a hot area is painted white, then it reflects maximum heat and make the house comparatively cooler. Therefore, it is advised to paint white on the outer walls of the house. The next question is, give two examples of conductors and insulators. Conductor means which allow the heat to pass through it. Therefore, the examples are copper and iron. Both of them are metals, or generally we can say that all metals are good conductors of heat. Then insulators, wood, plastic, paper, rubber, all these are examples of insulators. The last question is a diagrammatic question. Look at the figure and mark where the heat is being transferred by conduction, convection and radiation. From the figure we can see that between the flame and the stand, the heat transfer is taking place by radiation. Between stand and the vessel, the heat transfer is taking place by conduction because both of them are in contact. And water in the vessel is getting heated up by the convection mode of heat transfer. So students, I hope you have understood all the exercise very well. Please write it down in your notebook. If you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. I will answer it as soon as possible. Thank you.